Come on.
After the closed-door meeting with His Holiness Pope Francis, Nabanja disclosed some of the issues discussed, including the refugee situation in Uganda and the recently passed anti-homosexuality law. According to Nabanja, the Pope lauded the Ugandan government for its open-door policy to refugees. However, Nabanja says that although the pontiff welcomed the new anti-homosexuality law, he asked for a review to deal with the death sentence. The Prime Minister also met the Cardinal in charge of administration at the Vatican to discuss ways of helping the country manage refugees and also develop the Namugongo Holy Shrine. In a related development, the Prime Minister also met several investment companies based in Italy under their umbrella organization, Genofederation of Italy Industry. The Prime Minister, who was flanked by the Executive Director of the Uganda Investment Authority, Dr. Robert Mokiza, told investors that Uganda is a hub for investment in East Africa and Central Africa.
I want to thank you for inviting us and for allowing us to be with you so that we can share experiences on how to move our sister countries forward. Uganda is a developing country, and Uganda is ready for investment. We have a number of policies that favor the investment. One of the policies that we have, he will be telling you all this in detail, is how to support our investment or our investors who come to invest in our country. It's a big policy, the incentives involved, and many other things. Then two, we have created an enabling environment for investment to flourish, peace and security. We have invested in energy, like she already told me, that some of your companies are in partnership with us.
I think Italy is suffering a heat wave. When you go towards the south of Italy, there is also rain. Really confusing weather. but that means investment in green investment is very critical globally. Uganda is the second most biodiverse country in the world. Second most biodiverse. So the opportunity for green investments in our country is absolutely huge. So you and tapping onto your skills, your technology, your innovation, green investment is going to need that, and you have that in Uganda.
The president of the Genofederation of Italian Industries expressed willingness to help Italian industries invest in Uganda.
The value of direct Italian investment in Uganda is still limited. The country political and economic indicators currently appear particularly promising for Italian businesses. Mm-hmm. And for example, Italy is leader in the sector of high-quality valves and flow control solution used in the market of oil and gas. An Italian company could easily match with your needs in this field with the potential to drive Uganda's industrial progress and at the same time supporting the export and the know-how of Italian mechanic industries.
The Genofederation of Italian Industries also supports Italian industries operating in Africa and Middle East countries. Report compiled by Ismail Kasoha for the news.